Hey, hello, what's up everyone? In this video, I'm going to teach you about the Dsum chart or the Saptamsha chart. So before beginning, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon and click that button. And if you have any doubt after watching this video, please do mention it in my below comment section, okay? So let's begin. So mainly, what is the main purpose of doing this D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart? See, the main purpose of doing this D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart is about mainly to see the children, the promising of children, whether you'll get children or not. Now, the first thing is that promising of children, okay. The second thing is that it is also seen for mainly your happiness of your children, whether you get happiness from your children or not, after the birth of your children. Now, it is also seen for your timing of your children, at what year, at what age you'll get your children particularly. So these are all the things that mainly the Saptamsha chart or the D7 chart is mainly seen for. Now, before directly getting into the D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart, first check this condition that I'm going to tell you in the birth chart or the D1 chart. In the birth chart or the D1 chart, check the condition of the first house and first house lord. Why first house and first house lord? Because it plays a major important role while creating a child or children. Whether you are interested in particularly creating a child or not. Now, after checking the first house and first house lord, check the condition of the fifth house and fifth house lord. Why fifth house and fifth house lord? It is a main Karaka house for your actually children. Right. So check what are the planets placed in the fifth house, check what are the planets aspecting the fifth house. Check whether if any malefic planet is placed in the fifth house or any benefic planet is placed in the fifth house. Check if any benefic or malefic planets is aspecting the fifth house. That is especially the function of benefics or function of malefic planets. Now, after checking all this, check the condition of the fifth house lord, where it is placed in your birth chart. So, check what are the planets conjuncting the fifth house lord and what are the planets aspecting the fifth house lord. That also plays a major important role in getting a children for a person or a parent. Now, after checking, check the condition of ninth house and ninth house lord. Why ninth house and ninth house lord? Because it is the bhava, according to the bhava bhavan, it is a fifth from the fifth. So, ninth house is fifth house from the 9th house is the house 5th from 5th, that is according to the Bhavat Bhavan. So if you count 5 houses from the 5th house, you'll get the 9th house. So that's also an important house for your children. So you check the condition of 9th house and 9th house not in your birth chart. Now after all checking all these conditions, check the Karaka planet for the children, that is Jupiter or the significant planet. So if Jupiter is very well placed in your birth chart, that represents that, or Jupiter aspecting the 5th house, sitting in the 5th house, or you need to check the condition on from the moon chart also, where Jupiter is placed. If Jupiter is sitting the fifth house from the moon, or Jupiter is aspecting fifth house from the moon chart, that shows that the person will surely get the children. Or if Jupiter is sitting in the first house, that also shows that person will surely get the children, and the person will also get happiness from the children. Now, after checking all these conditions, is this enough for it? No, that's wrong. See, you need to check even in the D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart. It's actually you're opening the fifth house of the birth chart, like microscopic view of the fifth house of the birth chart. That gives you D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart. In the Saptamsha chart, check the condition of the first house and first house lord, how it is placed. That's the main important thing. So for every individual during chart, you need to check the condition of the first house and first house lord. What are the planets placed in the first house? What are the planets aspecting the first house? Now, what are the planets conjuncted with the first house lord? Where is your first house lord is sitting in the D7 chart? What are the planets aspecting the first house lord of the D7 chart? So these are all the main things that you need to check. If you are, they are all very good. So if even it's some of the thing is bad, like average, like say for example, if first house has very benefic planet, but first house lord is having placed in a very bad place, that represents through your difficulty. Through delay of your children, you surely get children, but there will be some delay, there will be some difficulty in getting the children. Now, after checking this condition, check the condition of 5th house and 5th house lord, because the inner core of your 5th house in the D7 chart. So, it shows that if any planet is sitting in the 5th house, if any planet aspect in the 5th house, now check the condition of the 5th house lord, if any planet is conjuncted with the 5th house lord, planet aspecting the 5th house lord, that also shows the timing of your children. So, at what year, at what age you'll get children, that can be seen through the 5th house of the D7 chart. Now, after examining all these, check the condition of the 9th house and 9th house lord of the D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart. That can also play a major important role in a person's life. Now, After all checking all these conditions, check the condition of Jupiter. How Jupiter is placed in the Saptamsa chart. If it is exalted sign, if it is in both Trikon sign, own sign, or the friendly sign, especially the very good houses like 147, 10 or 159, or even in the 2 or 11th house. That also plays a major important role, bringing a promised child. Now, after checking the Jupiter's condition, check the transit. Okay, so what are the plans that you need to check? During the transit, check the condition of Jupiter, in which house the Jupiter is transiting. So whether the Jupiter is sitting in the fifth house while transiting or aspecting the fifth house, or you need to check the condition of the Saturn also, because Saturn also plays a major important role, because it represents your patience, whether you get the children or not, whether you are having that patience to get the children or not. That is also seen through planet Saturn. Now check the condition of Saturn during the transit. So where your Saturn is transiting the house. So whether it is aspecting the fifth house or not, fifth house lord or not, even Jupiter also, if it is aspecting the fifth house lord or not, that can also be seen. This condition can also be seen through in the Saptamsa chart, not even on the birth chart. Now after all checking these conditions, now check the condition of the Ashtakvarga. So how much points the fifth house is receiving, whether the fifth house is receiving very good points, and you need to check the condition of the fifth house lord, how much it is receiving. So after all checking all these conditions, come to the descent chart or the Saptamsa chart. Check the condition of planet moon, how it is sitting, because that represents your mind, whether you have that mood to create the particular children. That can be seen through the moon in the descent chart or the Saptamsa chart. Now after all checking all these conditions, now superimpose the D1 chart on the D7 chart or the Saptamsa chart. Now how to superimpose it? Check what is your ascendant in the birth chart, and check what is your ascendant in the D7 chart. Now after checking these two conditions, if the ascendant match, that means that, let's say for example your Sagittarius ascendant in your birth chart, and even Sagittarius ascendant in your D7 chart, that shows that Virgottama ascendant, that shows that clear indication for birth child is promised. And let's say for example, taking another example, if your ascendant is Libra ascendant, and in the D7 chart, if your ascendant is Gemini ascendant, that shows that they are both friendly towards each other, right? The Gemini ascendant and Libra ascendant, because the rulers are friendly towards each other. That is, for Gemini ascendant, Mercury is the ruler. For Libra ascendant, Venus is the ruler, right? So Mercury and Venus are friendly towards each other. So what happens here is, so when the ascendant are friendly towards each other, that also shows that promise for birth chart. Now after checking this condition, check the condition from the moon's chart also. So check the condition of the fifth house from the moon's chart. What are the planets placed in the fifth house? What are the planets aspecting the fifth house? What are the planets conjuncted with the fifth house lord? And where is your fifth house lord is placed? What are the planets aspecting the fifth house? So that planets Mahadasa and Antardasa aspecting the fifth house or fifth house lord can promise you a beautiful child. Now, after checking all these conditions, check the moon's condition in the Saptamsa chart as I told you earlier. Now, after all checking these conditions, superimposing, coming to the superimposing part. See, check the condition of the first house lord of the birth chart, where it is placed in the D7 chart or the Saptamsa chart. That also plays a major important role, because it tells you whether you are interested for making a child, for creating a child or not. Now, after checking the first house and first house lord, check the planet sitting in the fifth house and fifth house lord, how it is placed in the D7 chart. So, see, for example, let's say for example, your Aries ascendant itself. So, if the fifth house lord is placed in the fifth house, that is, sun is placed in the fifth house itself in the Aries ascendant, check the condition of sun in the D7 chart or the Saptamsa chart, how it is placed. If it is placed very well, then during that Mahadasa or Antardasa, you get a child or children, you will become a parent. Now, if not, then check the condition of the 9th house and 9th house lord. What are the parents placed in the 9th house or 9th house lord in the birth chart? Check that condition in the D7 chart or the Saptamsa chart, how it is placed. The 9th house lord of the birth chart, how it is placed in the D7 chart or the Saptamsa chart. That also plays a major important role in the person's life for bringing a child or becoming a parent. Now, after all checking all these conditions, check whether you'll get happiness from the children or not. That can be seen through the planet, Moon, Jupiter and Venus. Because Moon represents your mind, Moon is the significator for happiness. Jupiter represents your children, it's a character for children or significant for children, and Venus represent your luxurious life. After your children is born, whether you'll get vehicles, home, that thing, etc. and all properties and all. So those can be seen to the planet Venus also. See, check these three planets in the D7 chart or the Saptam chart, how it is placed. If it is placed very well, then surely you'll get very good happiness after when your children is born. Now, how to see that whether the person will get second children or not, second child or not. So if second child is can be seen, see first child or first children can be seen to the fifth house and fifth house lord of the birth chart and the D7 chart. Now second child or the second children can be seen through the 7th house lord of the birth chart or 7th house lord of the D7 chart or the Saptamsha chart. Okay, so let's say for example your first child is born. Let's say for example 5th house lord is placed in the 9th house. That represents after your first child is born, you get very good luck. You may travel for pilgrimage. Temples, you can even travel for the foreign lands also. Your fortune may rise because 9th house represents your luck, foreign dharma, your religion temples, religion places, and all. So, pilgrimage things and all. So, these are all the things foreign lands. So, these are our foreign trips. So, these are all the things are represented by 9th house. So, if 5th house is placed in 9th house after your first childbirth, it represents you may travel to the foreign land or you may travel to the pilgrimage. So, these are all the things it may represent. Your luck may also increase. Now, let's say for example, take second children. If second children is born, so for that 7th house lord should be seen. So if 7th house lord, let's say for example, if 7th house lord is placed in the 6th house, then it represents after his second children, that shows that there may be some health problems for you. It also shows that there may be like court cases you need to go. Even though if not court cases is there, then you may face accidents. Vehicle accident after your second child is born. So these are all the things it happens when 7th house lord is in the 6th house for the second children. You need to check the condition of the 7th house lord in the birth chart and in the D7 chart. For a third child or the third children, you need to check the condition of 9th house and 9th house lord. Likewise for the fourth children, you need to check the condition of the 11th house and 11th house lord. Fifth children, 1st house and 1st house lord. Like that, even for the 6th children, 6th child, you need to check the condition of 3rd house and 3rd house lord. For 7th child, check the condition of 5th house and 5th house lord. So, this was my analysis, guys. So, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe below. Or else, I will see you in the next video, that is planet through the 4th house of D9 in the Vamsa chart. So, until then, thank you, bye-bye, love you, take care.